on back. Does that feel all right? Good. Come on back and touch. Good. Now, from there, I might have her do a set. She's cleared hot for a set. And it's not until she's had several doses from horizontal that I would let her go back and hyperextend and touch alternate arms. Very advanced movement. By the way, this sit-up is a potent hip flexor move. And there are people, exercise physiologists generally, that will tell you there's no shortening of the midline, there's no trunk flexion, therefore this is not an ab movement. Anyone ever heard anything like that? Watch this, and keep it all open. Just hip flex up. Boom. That line stayed nice and full open. Now you can do some flexion on the way up, but it's not really under a load, and it's all fairly insignificant to the movement, and not at all required to get a brutal ab response. And it is isometric and powerful and enough to put a hurt on you that does muscle damage. So next time you come across an exercise physiologist that tells you that without trunk flexion, there's no ab work, give them a dose. But for everyone else that you love and care about and are working with, you need to expose them to gentle doses of this thing. And I wouldn't have them do more than like a set of 10, one of 8, maybe one of 6 in someone who's like the sit-up king on first exposure. Primary movers here are the hip flexors. But the hip flexors, we all know about the psoas. And a psoas comes off the femur and attaches to the lumbar spine and has a weak purchase on the pelvis. That if she goes back here and touches, now watch the leg, this is critical, and comes back up and touches, she's working with the psoas only here. As you come up here, now I've got this thing pulling somewhat in shear. You got that? It causes considerable discomfort in folks. And I'll tell you, that kind of fucks with my back. And there's a fix for it here. Because the psoas is a potent and well-positioned hip flexor, but there's one that has purchase on the pelvis and pelvis only, and that is rectus femoris, and it's a top piece of quadricep that attaches to the patellar tendon and to the kneecap. And if she will markedly extend her leg when coming up, I'm pulling from a big piece of hip flexor that pulls from the pelvis only, and it reduces any purchase and pull and some of the load that the psoas has to do from the lumbar spine. And for people that are traditionally, historically irritated in doing a sit-up here on the glute-ham developer, say, hey, I feel that in my low back, you can take that where instead of feeling it on one or two reps, they'll feel it out at number 15 or 20, then number 40 is 50. But the difference between sharply extending the leg coming up and not is very dramatic in the rate of closing of the angle, so dramatic in the dynamics and in the posture that I can be looking out there and see which one she's done. You can hear the difference. It's powerful. It's powerful. And what we're learning here is how to use the full complement of hip flexors.